स्टैंडर्ड 7 साइंस चैप्टर नंबर 3 फाइबर टू फैब्रिक। इन क्लास 6 यू हैव लर्न अबाउट सम फाइबर्स ऑब्टेन फ्रॉम प्लांट्स। यू ऑल्सो लर्न दैट वूल एंड सिल्क फाइबर्स आर ऑब्टेन फ्रॉम एनिमल्स। वूल इज ऑब्टेन फ्रॉम द फ्लीस, दैट इज हेयर ऑफ शीप और याक, एंड सिल्क फाइबर्स came from cocoons of the silk moth. Do you know which part of the sheep's body yields fiber? Are you aware how these fibers are converted into the woolen yarn that we buy from the market to knit sweaters? Do you have any idea how silk fibers are made into silk, which is woven into saris? In this chapter, we will try to find answers to this question. Animal fibers, wool and silk. Wool. Wool comes from sheep, goat, yak, and some other animals. These wool yielding animals bear hair on their body. એમની બોડી પર હેર હોય એ રિમૂવ કરવામાં આવે, જેમ આપણે આપણા હેર કટ કરીએ ને, ધ સેમ વે. ડુ યુ નો વાય ધીસ એનિમલ્સ હેવ અ થિક કોટ ઓર ઓફ હેર? બીકોઝ ધે આર લિવિંગ ઇન માઉન્ટેનિયસ એરિયા, રાઈટ? હેર ટ્રેપ અ લોટ ઓફ એર. એર ઇઝ અ પુઅર કન્ડક્ટર ઓફ હીટ, એઝ યુ વુડ લર્ન ઇન ચેપ્ટર 4. સો હેર કીપ ધીસ એનિમલ વોર્મ. હેરના કારણે એમની બોડી કેવી રહે છે? વોર્મ. એન્ડ વૂલ ઇઝ ડિરાઇવડ ફ્રોમ ધીસ હેરી ફાઈબર્સ. લેટ્સ સી how wool is obtained. See this. See, this wool is collected, then sent to factory, right? And where threads of wool are separated this way.
ओके तुमने फॉरवर्ड करो। ओके परफेक्ट
मोकलू चलो तुमने। हाँ हाँ ये बद्दू मोकलू तुमने एक 10 मिनट आपको खाली। ओके नाउ लाइक द हेयरी स्किन ऑफ शीप हैज टू टाइप्स ऑफ फाइबर दैट फॉर्म इट्स फ्लीस। फर्स्ट द कर्ल्स बियर्ड हेयर एकदम कर्ल्स हुए एंड द फाइन सॉफ्ट अंडर हेयर क्लोज टू द स्किन बे टाइप नो ऊपर नो होय ने रफ होय અને અંદરનું જે એના હેર હોય એકદમ સ્મૂથ હોય રાઈટ સેમ લાઈક અસ આપણે બી ઉપરના હેર કેવા હોય રફ અને નીચેથી હેર જે આવે એ કેવા હોય સ્મૂથ હોય રાઈટ સમ બ્રીડ્સ ઓફ શીપ પઝેસ ઓનલી ફાઇન અંડર હેર એન્ડ ધેર પેરેન્ટ્સ આર સ્પેશિયલી ચૂઝન ટુ ગીવ બર્થ ટુ શીપ વિચ હેવ ઓનલી સોફ્ટ અંડર હેર ધીસ પ્રોસેસ ઓફ સિલેક્ટિંગ પેરેન્ટ્સ ફોર ઓબટેનિંગ સ્પેશિયલ કેરેક્ટર્સ ઇન ધેર અપસ્પ્રિંગ such as soft underhair in sheep is termed as a selective breeding. Another animals that yield wool. Several breeds of sheep are found in different parts of our country. However, the fleece of sheep is not the only source of wool. Though wool commonly available in the market is sheep wool, yak wool is common in Tibet and Ladakh. Mohair is obtained from Angora goats found in hilly regions such as Jammu and Kashmir. Right? Angora goats found in Jammu and Kashmir. Wool is also obtained from goat hair. The under fur of Kashmiri goat is soft. It is woven into fine shawls. Called Pashmina shawls. The fur on the body of camel is also used as a wool. Llama and alpaca found in South America also yield wool. આ બંનેને તમારે જોવા હોય llama and alpaca તો તમને અત્યારે સ્ટેચ્યુ ઓફ યુનિટીમાં જે પાર્ક ઝૂ બન્યું છે રાઈટ ફોર ફોર સફારી ત્યાં જોવા મળે both animals I have recently seen them alpaca and llama collect pictures of animals whose hair is used as a wool stick them in the your scrapbook if you are unable to get picture try and draw them from the ones given in this book find out words for sheep goat camel and yak in your local language and also in other language of our country Let me show you llama and alpaca. See. એટલે થોડી થોડી વાર એની બોડી પર ક્રીમ લગાડે એને વાગે નહીં એટલે See, complete body fur is removed. Same alpaca.
Sir, her inside skin was brown.
આપણે હેરકટ કરે ને એવી રીતે કરે છે.
Yes, sir.
Okay, shall we move forward?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Now, from fibers to wool. For obtaining wool, sheep are red. Their hair is cut and processed into wool. Let us learn about this process. Rearing and breeding of sheep. If you travel to the hills in Jammu and Kashmir, Himachal Pradesh, Uttaranchal, Arunachal Pradesh and Sikkim, or the plains of Haryana, Punjab, Rajasthan and Gujarat, you can see shepherds taking their herd of sheep for grazing. Sheep are herbivores and prefer grass and leaf. Apart from grazing, sheep prefers sheep rearers also feed them on a mixture of pulses, corn, jowar, all cakes, that is material left after taking out oil from seed and minerals. In winter, sheep are kept indoors and fed on leaves, grain and dry fodders. Sheep are reared in many parts of our country for wool. Table 3.1 gives the name of some breeds of sheep reared in our country for producing wool. The quality and texture of the fibers obtained from them is also indicated in the table. Certain breeds of sheep have thick coat of hair on their body, which yield good quality wool in large quantity. As mentioned earlier, these sheep are selectively bred, with one parent being a sheep of good breed. Once the red sheep has developed a thick growth in hair is shaved off for getting wool. Processing fiber into wool. The wool, which is used for knitting sweaters or for weaving shawls, is the finished product of a long process, which involves the following steps. Sheep 1. The fleece of the sheep along with a thin layer of skin is removed from its body. This process is called shearing. Machines similar to those used by barbers are used to shave off hair. Usually hair are removed during the hot weather. This enables sheep to survive without their protective coat of hair. The hair provide woolen fibers. Woolen fibers are then processed to obtain woolen yarn. Shearing does not hurt the sheep, just as it does not hurt when you get a hair cut or your father shaves his beard, right? તમાર પપ્પા દાઢી કરે તો થોડી છોલાઈ જાય છે, right? એના જેવું છે. Do you know why? The uppermost layer of skin is dead. Almost the hair of sheep grow again, just as your hair does. Now, name of breed Lohi, different type of sheep, quality of wool, good. Rampur Bashir, that is brown fleece. Nali, carpet wool. Bakharwal for woolen shawl. Marwari, curse wool, and Patanwadi for hosiery. These last two are in Gujarat, and uppermost are Rajasthan, Punjab, Uttar Pradesh, Himachal Pradesh, Jammu and Kashmir, and Haryana.
Now step 2. The sheared skin with hair is thoroughly washed in tanks to remove grease, dust and hair. This is called a scoring. Nowadays, scoring is done by machines. After scoring, sorting is done and the hairy skin is sent to a factory where hair of different textures are separated or sorted. Step 4. The small fluffy fiber called the burrs are picked out from the hair. These are the same burrs which sometimes appear on your sweater. Jem sweater upar peli pooms vadi jai chhe ne ane burrs kevay. Right? E pan ama wool maathi nikle ane remove karvama aave. And the fibers are scored again and dried. This is a wool ready to be drawn into fiber. Emathi fibers bane. Now the fibers can be dyed in various color as the natural fleece of sheep and goat is black, brown or white. Natural kaya kaya colors why? Black, brown and white as why? The fibers are straightened, combed and rolled into yarn. The longer fiber are made into wool for a sweater and the shorter fibers are spun and woven into woolen clothes. The processing of fiber into wool can be represented as follows: shearing, scoring, sorting, cleaning of burrs, rolling and dyeing. Now next is silk. Silk fibers are also animal fiber. Silkworms spin the silk fiber and the rearing of silkworms for obtaining silk is called sericulture. Find out from your mother, aunt or grandmother the kind of silk sari they have. List the kind of silk before we discuss the process of obtaining silk. It is necessary to know the interesting life history of the silk moth. Let me show you. Lifestyle of silk moth.
एकदम ना पहले हाथ पास में चू हाँ चालू छे करू अरे साढ़े नौ करू
Sir, what is this ball?
Seen the cocoon coming out of it? Seen or not?
Yes, sir.
Haven't seen? Sorry, not this one. It's of butterfly. Now see.
Sir, we have only 11 minutes.
એની અંદર રહેલા જે ઇન્સેક્ટ છે એ મરી જાય એટલા માટે આ રીતે ગરમ પાણીમાં નાખવામાં આવે કુકન્સ ને. સી ધેર લાઈવ, દેખાય છે, હલે છે. કેન યુ સી?
યસ સર.
હા, હવે 10,000 કુકન્સ બર્ન થઈ જાય, મરી જાય, પછી એમાંથી સિલ્ક નીકળે. એટલે ઇન્ડિયામાં રાઈટ નાઉ ઇટ ઇઝ બેન્ડ. ક્લિયર?
યસ સર.
જો ગોળ ગોળ ફેરવતો જાય કુકર ને, એટલે એમાંથી તાર છૂટા પડતા જાય, અને એ તાર એ તમારા સિલ્ક ના તાર હોય. પ્યોર સિલ્ક ઇઝ મેડ લાઈક ધીસ વે. નાઉ નેક્સ્ટ, લાઈફ હિસ્ટ્રી ઓફ સિલ્ક મોથ. ધ ફિમેલ સિલ્ક મોથ લેઝ એગ્સ ફ્રોમ વિચ હેચ લાર્વા which are called caterpillar or silkworm. They grow in size, and when the caterpillar is ready to enter the next stage of its life history called pupa, it first weaves a net to hold itself. Then it swings its head from side to side in the form of figure of 8. Right? 8. During this movement of head, the caterpillar secretes fiber made of protein which hardens on exposure to air. જે તમે હમણાં વ્હાઇટ જોયા એ, રાઈટ, એન્ડ બીકમ સિલ્ક ફાઈબર. સૂન ધ કેટરપિલર કમ્પ્લીટલી કવર્સ ઇટ સેલ્ફ બાય સિલ્ક ફાઈબર એન્ડ ટર્ન્સ ઇન ટુ પુપા. ધીસ કવરિંગ ઇઝ નોન એઝ અ કુકન. ધ ફર્ધર ડેવલપમેન્ટ ઓફ પુપા ઇન ટુ મોથ કન્ટિન્યુઝ ઇનસાઇડ ધ કુકન. અંદર એમાંથી ઈયળ બનવાની શરૂઆત થઈ ગઈ હોય. સિલ્ક ફાઈબર્સ આર યુઝ ફોર વિવિંગ સિલ્ક ક્લોથ. કેન યુ ઇમેજિન ધેટ ધ સોફ્ટ સિલ્ક યાર્ન ઇઝ એઝ સ્ટ્રોંગ એઝ અ કમ્પેરેબલ થ્રેડ ઓફ સ્ટીલ. ધ સિલ્ક યાર્ન ઇઝ ઓબટેન્ડ ફ્રોમ ધ કુકન ઓફ ધ સિલ્ક મોથ. ધેર ઇઝ અ વેરાયટી ઓફ સિલ્ક મોથ્સ વિચ લુક વેરી ડિફરન્ટ ફ્રોમ વન અનધર, એન્ડ ધ સિલ્ક યાર્ન ધે યીલ્ડ is a different in texture. Thus, tussar silk, munga silk, kosa silk, etc. are obtained from kukans spun by different type of moth. The most common silk moth is the Malabari silk moth, the best one. The silk fiber from the kukan of this moth is soft, lustrous and elastic, and can be dyed in beautiful colors. Sericulture, growing of this moth is called a sericulture or a culture of silkworm, is very old occupation in India. India produce plenty of silk on a commercial scale. Now activity 3.5. Collect pieces of silk cloth of various types and paste them in your scrapbook. You can find them in a tailor shop among the heap of waste cut pieces. Take help of your mother, aunt or teacher and identify the types of silk such as Malabari, Tassar, Era and Munga silk. Let me show you the video on this types of silk.
તમને ઇન્ડિવિડ્યુઅલી દરેક સેન્ટેન્સને ઇન્ફોર્મેશન મોકલું કે તમને પહેલા એ મોકલ્યામાંથી મળી જશે.
Okay. Clear different types of silk sarees.
Yes, sir.
Now, take an artificial silk thread and a pure silk thread. Burn this thread carefully. Did you notice any difference in the smell while burning? Burn a woolen fiber carefully. Did it smell like burning of artificial silk or that of pure silk? Can you explain why? Remember, when the Kukan stage is reached in the life history of silk moth, try the following activity. Activity 3.7. Photocopy figure 3.9. Cut out pictures of the stage of life history of silk moth and paste them on a piece of cardboard or a chart paper. Jumble them. Now try and arrange the stages in the correct sequence in a cyclic form. Whoever does it fast, it fastest win? You may also describe the life history in your own words. Write it down in your scrapbook. From Kukan to Silk. This video we have already seen, right? Just we are reading. Okay, we'll do it in the next lecture. From Kukan to Silk, page number 7.